An important example factor when you do machine learning is to actually have a good metrics to evaluate things. And often we divide our metrics into two groups, the positive examples and negative examples. And you want to do good in both groups. And you can see that here, as you have like a positive example, so the red circle, and blue negative example, the blue circle. And you basically want to have a cutoff of a score that separates these groups. And often there are overlappers, you're not doing a perfect job. So if you have a cutoff here, which is, for instance, this line here, you will have some true positives that are predicted, that are in a positive group and predicted to be positive, and some false negatives that are in the positive group but are wrongly predicted to not be belong to the class. And the same, you will have some false positives that are predicted in the negative examples, that then belong to the negative examples but are predicted to be positive, and then you have some true negatives. And if you use these numbers, you can actually do a number of things. You can calculate what's called precision, recall, true positive rate, false positive rate, false recovery rate, etc. And in particular, you can calculate what's called Matthews correlation coefficient. That's a very good number because it actually relates to something that is easy to interpret. So it's basically 0 for random, 1 for perfect, and -1 for completely imperfect.